Hello? There we go. All right. Tried pressing the F3 key on my actual keyboard. Looks like the emulator is making sound. Sure, okay. Let's go ahead and get this started. Oh, I hit the wrong button. Okay. There we go. Hello, Jetstorm. Okay, so I think. No, wait. We're still sailing, aren't we? Not at the ruins yet. I noticed. Yeah. You got to the first boss, I hear. Hopefully, we might be seeing some of that during this stream. She is so good. All right, let's see. Can't talk to the goat. Ooh, title drop. It's funny because he dropped a contact, and that's the name of the game. Huh. Chilled juice, I know how to make that. Where's Troy with his Dune jokes when you need him? Do I want to use a key? Wait, how many keys do I have? I believe keys are consumable, so what the hell not. Oh, my karma went down. I used a key to steal someone's book. Well, that was a... That was totally worth it. Looks like we're going to the Demon Gate. Wherever that is. I suppose I could afford to up my hand-to-hand combat skills. Wait, there was a guy back there. Way, dog. Oh, yes, please. That's just a regular dang old knife. Alrighty. Oh wait, no, the professor said he had something he wanted to invent for me or something? Yeah. Why, yes, Poncho, this is that there contact game. Not sure what that was, but it's probably important somewhere. That's a familiar name. Demon Zone sounds ominous. I should probably switch to my Water Ninja outfit. If I can remember how to do that. Right, from the ship. Okay. For some reason, I thought Terry could just switch out outfits from the fly. Yeah, Poncho, this game so far is turning out to be kind of mother-esque, yeah. I feel like I should save before attempting to open any sort of demon's gate. Just seems like good JRPG logic right there. The game's sense of humor kind of is what gives me that sort of mother vibe, or at least to me. But yeah, that professor guy does look a lot like Dr. Andonuts. This game itself kind of, for whatever reason, like, the look of it kind of reminds me of, it kind of reminds me of Tales of Phantasia or Star Ocean on the Super Nintendo. I'm not paying attention at all, am I? Oh crap, I don't even have anything equipped. Wrong button. Better equip something. I got a grasshopper. The DS and 3DS are like bastions for JRPGs, I've noticed. There's just a lot of really good ones for both systems. Oh, a timed segment. That's I don't even know where this gate is. Ooh, that was close. You know, I still want to check out that fan translation of the first Seventh Dragon for the DS. That seems like a game that'd be up my alley. That sort of Dragon Quest-y sort of vibe. Saga 2 for the DS is also surprisingly playable. But this is coming from someone who enjoyed the original on the Game Boy too. So, take that with a grain of salt. Oh, and the miniature RPG in the first Retro Game Challenge, that's legit, like, one of my favorite portable RPGs. Like, it's just, it's small, but also really good. Like, it is just a really good Dragon Quest clone. I couldn't really get into The World Ends With You for whatever reason. I just couldn't really get into having to use the touchscreen and the buttons for the battle system. But I mean, this was like years and years ago. If I were to try it out now, I'd probably have a little more patience for it. Sands of Destruction. I don't think I've heard of that one. Lower my strength, though. Maybe not right now. Oh, cheeseburgers don't really recover that much health, huh? I've heard that too, Poncho, about the Dark Spire. Like, I hear it's a lot more wizardry-esque than, say, the Etrian Dungeon the Etrian Odyssey games. I still need to make, like, progress in the first Etrian Odyssey. I think I'm still stuck on, like, the third floor of the first stratum. Progress in that game is just really glacial, the first Etrian Odyssey. I imagine that they've kind of improved on that for, like, entries 4 and 5. wasn't even aiming at that spider. It works for me. I have not actually played Radiant Historia. I hear it handles time travel in an interesting way, but the kind of, like, thorough beating that Polly gave it during one of the Soxcast episodes, that's kind of dissuaded me from, like, really looking into it. I would put a tub and a bed out here. I think we're getting close to the boss. I know she isn't. Otherwise, I wouldn't. I'm not sure where I was going with that statement, but yeah. Isn't the solution here. Strange Journey is another game I should really look into. Oh, I'm affected by some sort of status effect. Ah. Okay, and it looks like I'm kind of dying here. I just realized I'm this close to a bath. Why am I using consumable healing items? And hey, let's just save for good measure. Thank you. Oh, so it looks like I'm gonna be getting a new set of duds later. Probably should have saved that water spell. Maybe I don't want to really attack both of them at once. I kind of want to see the Majin Tensei games for the Super Nintendo translated. The first few Shin Megami Tensei strategy games. Those look pretty neat. Oh, this thing is doing some mad damage. Trickle's really good. Got a key. Really, another bed? It looks very Fire Emblem-y. Majin Tensei. I know the second game has some really good music too. From the guy who composed the music for the first two Persona games, actually. Oh, okay, yeah. I remember this part of the dungeon. So that just takes me to the entrance. I guess I could wail on some spiders a bit to maybe build up my gauge. So I can throw armor break. I mean, I guess it makes sense because both halves of the dungeon are kind of separated by that timed gate thing. Oh wait, no, the gate's not even there anymore. Never mind. Alright, I've got a full gauge, and I'm ready to take on some more of the dungeon. Thank you. Wait, it looked like there was something over here. Uh-huh. Just as I thought. I very briefly had a cartridge for Superstar Saga. And I liked like the first hour or so of gameplay I was able to get into it. But then I had to sell it for to pay some bills, and that really saddened me. I should really get back into that, like, one day. Because I hear those Mario and Luigi games are pretty good. And, like, the first Paper Mario is pretty much, like, if not my favorite N64 game, one of my favorite N64 games, and I hear that the Mario and Luigi games kind of channel a lot of that quirky spirit. Yeah, I had to sell like a ton of my games last year because one of my cats were dying and I got into a car wreck. Sadly, the cat died, but my car recovered. Wait, aren't they remaking Superstar Saga for the 3DS? Like Bowser's Minions or something? Or maybe that's like a... Maybe it's like Superstar Saga from, like, the perspective of Bowser's Minions? I don't know, I've just seen, like, cardboard displays at my work for it, and I'm not really sure what it's for. I might actually pick that up. Might be a nice way to give Superstar Saga another shot. Okay, you need to die. Like, right now. I'm getting a lot of rotten meat. I'm not sure how I'm gonna be able to incorporate that in any dishes. And I'm pretty sure I can't really eat it raw. Like, that'd be stupid. Don't I have, like, an armor break? Whatever. Ooh, Super Mario 3D Land is getting the Nintendo Selects treatment. That is a... I should probably check that out once it gets discounted. Because that's another game I've been looking to get into, the Super Mario 3D Land and 3D World games. Here they're real good. I'm not quite sure how whacking things with this Ankh thing gave me book smarts, but that's apparently a thing that just happened. Awesome. Ooh. This game likes its secret passageways, I've noticed. Ah, god. Go away. I would make a snarky comment about the quality of console Zelda games, but honestly, I think the last console Zelda I've played was, like, Wind Waker. And that was actually on, like, an emulator, so... Yeah, I'm not too well-versed in 3D console Zeldas. Wait, I haven't even healed yet. Yes, this is. This is totally a game. That grunt sounded very Doom-esque. Now, Wet Stew, Troy, whatever. No need to be putting predictions here. Oh, right, yeah. I should probably heal. Am I close to a bed? Or a... A tub? I should probably heal regardless, whatever. ...40 HP... That would not be bad. I could maybe whack a few enemies to... No? You know what? Shoot. Should I go back and save? Or should... Let's go back and save. Enemies are easy to avoid, so... Shouldn't be that difficult. Oh, is that so? Okay. So I guess there isn't a penalty for dying. Hey, maybe I can use that key here. Is the club? Pretty useful, huh? Okay. Goodness, enemies here hit pretty frickin' hard. Hmm. kind of love how enemies just are able to chase you down from other rooms in the dungeon. So it looks like the club has Jetstorm 4's seal of approval. Let's see here. Okay, it reduces speed, but ups my offense quite a bit. And my critical hit percentage. Often. Oh, that's what that does. Wish there was a way to switch between targeted enemies. Or maybe I'm just not hitting the right button. Go ahead and heal up, and then save, and head straight for the boss. Ah, that's right, yeah, I guess I can pick out enemies with the stylus, or in this case, with the mouse cursor. The mochi for good luck. Go ahead and equip the Mage's Rod, because it gives me a bit of a boost in, I guess, spell power, and I plan on using Trickle quite a bit. Oi. That guy hits hard, too. Okay, so what could we have done better, I wonder? I'm starting to think standing in one place and casting one spell isn't going to do me much good against him. Is that thing running away from me? That's great. I wonder if I beat Lester, will I be getting his clothing, which will probably unlock the, like, the Phantom Thief or whatever outfit? Am I literally going to be beating the pants off of this guy? Steak. Not to be confused with a meat steak. Speaking of which, I probably should have cooked a few things before re-embarking. I guess the Shadow Thief duds aren't until later in the game. Let me hit you! God, there we go. Questionable decal, huh? Speaking of which, I haven't really even been using these decal things. Probably should have saved that for when I wanted to build up my meter. Not like it's going to really matter, though. check? What check? Oh. Oh, you're just having issues with your... Okay. I thought I was missing something. Oh, right, they chase you. Hidden away. Okay. Why am I getting into these fights? I should probably get to actually fighting the boss. Though I guess the increase in experience isn't so bad. Okay, I gotta get out of here. The level up system in this game does, like, remind me a lot of Saga. Specifically Saga 2, where I know by using certain equipment, you'll increase the likelihood of increasing certain stats. Excuse me, Mr. Monster. Okay, Lester, take two. Wait, let's see, maybe there's something I can eat that'll increase my chances of winning. So his attacks actually interrupt my magic spell casting. That's distressing. I'm at least faster than this guy, so that... Alright, See you in a bit, Jetstorm. Yes, I will be uploading a highlight of this. But anyway, see ya, Troy. Ooh, stabby thing. I like cloud sword. It's too thin to be a cloud sword. Radioed me just to tell me that. Good to know. Oh boy, more enemies. Better heal up. And we're back. These pink Mewtwo looking things aren't too hard to kill. Don't really hit too hard either. Oh, never mind. Gosh, just as I say that. After this dungeon, I'm probably going to be doing a whole lot of cooking to make up for all the items I used. Oh boy. So this is the boss. Ow. Okay. That still hurt me. This kind of reminds me of Sword of Mana, or Secret of Mana, except you can actually dodge attacks. This isn't too bad. Shit, go away. Gosh, I should have built up some more meter. Shit. Okay, this sucks. This sucks. I can't eat the grasshopper, can I? Well, I think I'm done for. I should bring more barbecue chicken. That's the moral of the story. Like, that is what I gathered from this. is this? Oh, I can't just cook straight rotten meat. That's a little disappointing. You don't have to be watching football to be getting wings. Any day's a good day for wings. What the hell is that? A chunk of carbon, my favorite. And chicken, what is that gonna make? Nope, okay. Okay, let's give sardines another go. Ooh, veggie and bean chili. I'd like to eat more chili, but neither my sister or my boyfriend, or my sister's boyfriend, are really into things with beans in them. If I just fry a potato. Nope. I guess fried potatoes just aren't a thing in this game. I don't believe I've ever had quinoa. I like mixing lentils in my rice, though. That gives it an interesting texture. Luck had to run out sometime. Momo, get away from the screen. I'm trying to play here. Okay, let's go out and fight the big mean monster masher thing. Momo, I would really appreciate it if you weren't in front of the screen like that. I think I'm just gonna stick with buttons. Playing with the stylus might be a viable option if I actually had a stylus to play with. I like how these monsters are just totally cool with you just pushing them out of the way. I don't believe I've had Wheat Bulgar or Tabouli. Sounds interesting. I know we have a few halfway decent Middle Eastern restaurants around here, it's just I haven't really been able to go all that often as of late. Ouch. Gotta love those attacks that you can't actually avoid. Like, that's real good. Real good shit. Welcome back, Jetstorm. I'm fighting a big rock monster. Ah, yes, the golem. Classic Jewish mythology monster. Okay, that... Give me that chicken. Oh, I'm getting to be full. Momo, I really need you to get out of the way. I'm gonna need to seal it now. Important to your interests, huh? Wonder. Akira Ueda. Why, yes, Poncho, that is kind of how stylus tapping is simulated on this DS emulator. Oops. So I can actually, like, hold down parts of the screen to simulate me tapping it, or drag the mouse, like, so, yeah. It doesn't feel as good as actually using a stylus, but... Oh, he did Love to Lick and Moon RPG Remix. I've read about those on, Hardcore Gaming 101. They sound interesting. What was the development house behind those games? Shoot. Those are some weird ass games. I guess it's kind of fitting that he would go on to work on this game, too. Oh. Oh, yeah, I see now. Okay. For some reason, I thought Love to Lick was, like, one of their games. Let's see if that spice lady has spice for us. Hmm. sushi. Lack of love, that's what it was. Yeah, I know Love Delicted, Lack of Love, Moon RPG Remix, and then there's that one game where, like, you control a group of visiting aliens, and you have to observe, like, this human family in this one house and build up a spaceship or something. Yeah, that's what it was. It's been a while since I've read that hardcore gaming article. Oh wait, that's a time limit. Oh shit, I better head off. So what is it? Just gonna let me redo this? I didn't know that was timed. Oh gosh. Okay. Get it all the way back. Chicken. Ooh. UFO, A Day in the Life. That, yeah. That's probably it. Yeah, that is it. Okay. Coffee. We can make coffee beans. No, we can make coffee with coffee beans. Ask a grown up. I don't know, should I go back into that dungeon and maybe try to look for that Phantom Thief outfit? I ask that as I head into the dungeon looking for that Phantom Thief outfit. If anything, it'll be a good way to grind up some skill points and chicken. Shadow Thief. Okay, can't go in there yet. Can't go in there either. I feel like I should be able to go through here, but that's obviously not the case. And that's just another door I can't open. Right then, okay. Let's see. guess there's a chest in here. Whoa, that thing explodes. That took me for a surprise. Forgot I had this sword. I attack a lot quicker. Don't hit as hard though. Momo, I'm gonna need you to get out of the way. I'm trying to play. No, 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 no. Go, 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 go. Shoot, 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 shoot. While I would normally pet that Momo, I think in this case it would only exacerbate the problem. Also, he looks very comfy where he is right now. Ooh, apple. I wonder if I find any pine, I might be able to make a pineapple. I might have to put in my slash damage doesn't do well with skeletons. Might have to put what's this? Oh. It's nothing I can get right now. What was I going to say? Oh right, webcam. If only so I can So I guess you guys can see more of Momo, because he's a cutie pie. Trickle is so useful. Okay, and of course I can't go through here. yeah, my HP is getting low. I'm not sure how I missed that. Having no luck finding this outfit, though. I think I'm gonna look around a bit more, and then... and then I'm going to save and... I'm not that tired yet, so I might actually switch over to my other computer and start doing some Operation C practice. If watching someone repetitively practice a speedrun is kind of your thing, then I guess stick around. But for now, I'm gonna... well, for now, I'm gonna keep looking for that outfit. But if I can't find it here in a few, then I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to Operation C. Cheeseburger. And there I thought I found the Shadow Thief outfit. No, it was just a cheeseburger. Don't you just hate it when that happens? Okay, it has to be somewhere in this corridor. Like, I can think of no other place it could be in. Well, I mean, finding a cheeseburger in and of itself is always good. It's just... it's the expectations. You expect a... you expect new clothes, and you get a cheeseburger. I mean, try thinking of it in the inverse. Like, you go expecting a cheeseburger, and you're suddenly gifted new clothes. Like, the end result is still good, it's just... didn't get what you were expecting, and kind of throws you for a loop. I'm not sure... this thing's going to kill me. Oh. Or not. Okay. Yeah, there sure isn't a... outfit here. Would it be somewhere in the village, I wonder? That's right, huh? So I won't need a death warp, okay. Oh yeah, and I got some mystery decals, too. Oh, I gotta apply it, okay. Hmm. Don't tell me I missed, like, a ship decal somewhere. That might be it, yeah. But I don't remember using it at all, ever. Anyway, I've got some things I want to do in the village anyway, so it's no big deal. Plus, all this walking helps me increase my speed, so it's all good. It's all good. At least I got chicken. Got that water. Not sure what I'm gonna do with it, but I have it. Said there was a special on herbs. They're the normal price. Whatever. I guess we could get some bread too. I don't think I have a paper knife. Not sure what I'd use a paper knife for, but I've got it. Oh boy, looks like I'm gonna have to go back in that cave and save a kid from monsters. Okay, so it was a room with, oh, That was easy. Get stuck in the level geometry, dude. I don't suppose the enemies can attack our little NPC friend, because that would really suck. Well, I think we've hit a pretty good stopping point for now. Let's go ahead and heal up. And save for now. Alright, it's 9:27. I'm probably going to hop on to my other computer and practice speedrunning Operation C. You guys are welcome to stick around for that. but anyone else, thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys next time for whenever I decide to stream Contact, because I can't find my DS, so I guess I might just continue playing this on the computer, which is fine, honestly, because this plays pretty well on the computer. But anyway, thank you so much. Thank you, Jetstorm. Thank you, Poncho. And thank you, Troy, if you're still lurking, for joining me on the stream. See you guys in a bit.